Hey guys, good morning. It's 9:25. I'm on call right now. It was nice while it lasted. I don't even know that I talked about having to work today, yesterday, probably because I anticipated being on call. I knew today was a little iffy because it's Good Friday and like doctor's offices are closed. All of the women's lady part offices, OBGYNs, are closed. At least for the hospital. So they didn't have like very many inductions or C-sections scheduled. So I kind of knew today was a little toss up whether I would be on call or not. Who knows, it may get busy earlier and later. I can't even talk. May get busy later in the day and they may call me in. So I guess we'll see. But right now I'm on call. They called me about 4 o'clock this morning. So I got to sleep in a little bit until 8. And now all the girls are home, everyone's out of school. Andres is at a chiropractor appointment, and initially, because I was gonna have to work, he was gonna take all of them with him. So now that I didn't have to work, I told him, go ahead and go to the appointment and, you know, enjoy your relaxing adjustment and massage and everything without them having to be there. That it would have been a nightmare had he had to take them. So it ended up working out. I finished up with some breakfast. I had some grapes and one of our freezer burritos. So anyway, I'm looking a hot mess as always. As soon as he gets home, I'm gonna go take a shower. That way, if I do have to go to work, I can just up and leave. I don't have to worry about getting ready and stuff. The girls are sitting on the floor
making a parade,
playing. Autumn's down there playing
with a toy puppy.
And I am watching on my phone my brother's cheesecake, raspberry cheesecake cookies. I've been in the mood. I have bought butter because per y'all's recommendation, butter is better than margarine. And I knew that. I actually learned a long time ago that margarine, or like the type of butter that comes in the country crock, like those type of bins, or like a molecule away from plastic or some crap. So I was thinking it can't be good for your body, which I knew that, but it's usually lower in calories, blah blah blah. So I bought butter when I was at Costco last time because a lot of you were like, oh, just use butter. If you could use a smaller portion of it, it's better for you than margarine. So I bought it, and now I've been kind of, it's so much butter. Can you freeze butter? I've never even thought about that, but it's so much butter that I feel like I wanna make just like a little tiny sweet treat. I have chocolate chips, maybe like chocolate chip cookies. And then I saw my brother, which I'll have his channel link down below. He does a lot of cooking videos, and all of his cooking and baking videos are from scratch. So I was looking to see the base of his raspberry cheesecake cookies because I have I have cream cheese, a butter, sugar, all that good stuff. I don't have raspberries, but I have other stuff that I can make the cookies out of. So I was looking at the base of his cookie so I could get an idea, and just waiting for them to start because I'm sure they'll start bickering at some point. I try and have faith, but
I thought you were going to a party.
It'll happen at some point. Look at these children. They have capes on front and back with their Mickey crowns from Disney and Ice the other day.
And we are
at the little walking track park in the neighborhood, and we're letting the girls burn off some steam. There's actually a playground here, but I think we brought the soccer ball, the volleyball, jump rope, the helicopter, like things for them to do. And I'm just gonna walk around while they run and get some exercise. And also, hurry mama! So that way they can burn off some energy. We'll go home, have lunch, and then they can go down for a quiet time and a nap. And I'm still on call as of right now. It's 12:08, so I figured why not get some exercise, right? Then we'll go home, have lunch. Like I said, I'll figure out dinner, put them down for a nap, work on some Etsy stuff from that sale. I'm like so overwhelmed, but which is awesome. I love it. So I'll start working on that and then just wait. And if they don't call me, then they don't call me. Baby.
Hey.
I think you broke the thing.
No.
Kick the soccer ball, Maddie. Yeah. Autumn! Hey, Mom! Hi, the gorgeous. We're gonna have a great summer. She can push Autumn, and I can go running.
Can we play?
Yeah. Autumn with the one finger. Yeah. Hi. With just the one finger. I see that tooth. Hi. 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 Say, leave me alone, Dad. I'm fine. Tell him. Say, leave me alone. I'm fine. Woo. Woo! 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 Say, look at my tooth.
Let me see if I can get it.
Outdoor activities, check. Got everyone taking a nap. I am going to take a relaxing shower. Even Emmy is in her room having a quiet time watching TV. Just got Maddie down for a nap. Autumn was super fighting her nap, but I even got her down. Now I'm going to take a shower, put some makeup on and film. This is like four hauls right here, four. I want it up off my floor. And if I have time, I'm gonna try. It's 2:45 right now, I'm still on call. I'm sure they're not gonna call me in at this point. I wouldn't even have to be there till four. I doubt it, hopefully not. But I'm all nasty, my hair's gross. So I need to take a shower, get it done. I'm gonna do all these haul videos, start putting everything away. I'm going to try and dust and vacuum my room, move my jewelry on more, make my bed, and kind of straighten up my vanity all before 6 o'clock. I mean, that's 3 hours, all before dinner time, let's put it that way. I think tonight for dinner, we're gonna have meatloaf. I have a turkey, tube of turkey in the fridge. And we're gonna do turkey meatloaf. And for lunch, we did leftovers. So all of our leftovers are cleared out of the fridge, which is so good. I love when that happens. I love when I open my fridge and I don't have any leftovers in there. It makes me feel really good, like we didn't waste anything. Although I did have to throw out a sack of potatoes today, the little red potatoes, which I was very upset about because they smelled like something I would smell at the hospital. Nasty. They were nasty. So I did have to, they weren't bad. They just had like, one of them had a little patch that kind of tainted all the potatoes for me. So yeah, I think I'm either gonna do like scalloped potatoes or maybe corn on the cob with a green vegetable and double up on the veggies for meatloaf tonight. I don't think I have any instant potatoes. I don't know, we'll see. Who knows, I'm gonna try and get all this done, take a shower. We'll see how much I get done. I'll show you guys later. Huge change of plans. I got out of the shower, well, I took a shower. I got out of the shower, had every intentions of putting my hair curly because I was going to get it cut off this weekend, probably Sunday. And I went to go split my hair down the middle like I always do to brush it. And I noticed like a white spot at the like tip of my head. And I was like, what is that? I kind of bent down. I have a huge, huge, like in between a quarter and a half dollar size, a bald spot at the crown of my head right here. And I'm kind of like right here, like this I got with Maddie, this little bald spot. But it's huge, it's like that big. And it's the thing that I don't understand, I just started bawling, like bawling. I know it's just hair, like it's just hair, and there's, I just keep trying to tell myself, like there's people that have alopecia that lose it and can't grow it back. And there's people that are going through chemo and that have cancer that are gonna go entirely bald. And I get that. So like, I'm just having a pity party. So I'm sorry if I'm offending anyone. I'm truly, truly not trying to offend anybody. It just was a shock because I had already started to stop losing so much hair each time I was washing it and brushing it. And my bald spots up at the, not the crown, the, temples, up at my temples that I had from having autumn, have already started to fill in. So I'm just super surprised. Like now it's tender, like it hurts just the hair lying over it. And Andres was looking at it, and of course I was like boohoo crying to him, and he was like, it looks fresh, like I don't understand, did you use a different shampoo, looks like maybe you had a reaction because it's like it's all red. And I didn't. I mean, I was using the same shampoo and conditioner that I used the other day. And the thing is it could have been there for a little while. He said there's baby hairs like starting to grow from it. And it could have been there for a while now, I guess, but it hurts. That's what I don't understand. I said, well, if it's been there for a while, why is it tender? I mean, and I've had my hair up, I had it down the other day. No one said anything. I brushed it. I mean, I just took a shower a couple days. Like, I just washed it, I don't know, you guys probably know better than I do. I feel like I just washed it earlier in the week and I didn't know, I brushed my hair the same way every single time and I didn't notice it. And it didn't hurt. Like when I went to go brush over it today, it hurt. And I mean, it's a good chunk taken out. And so I don't know where I could have lost it. Like I didn't have an overly exaggerated amount of hair in the shower or in my brush or anywhere around on my pillow. Like, I mean, that it almost looks like somebody ripped a chunk, like grabbed it and yanked it, like I had gotten to a fight or something and somebody yanked my hair out of my head. It's huge and it's bright at the crown of my head, or you know what I mean, like where my part is at the top right here, it's right here, and it hurts, and I just don't understand what the heck happened. I don't know. So now, instead of waiting till Sunday, I was like, forget this. I was crying. The dress was like, go get your hair cut. Just go get it cut. It'll take the weight off. That way it won't pull it anymore. The bald spot won't get worse. And that way, you know, we can get you some biotin and just try and take it. And I'm just like devastated. I cannot believe this. I'm like almost embarrassed to go get my hair cut because I have this huge bald spot. Like I told him, even when I have my hair down, you're gonna be able to see it. So like the whole point of getting my hair cut was so that I could wear my hair down more and it wouldn't be so heavy and pull at the seams of my hair. The only thing I can hope and pray is that it grows back. I guess if it doesn't, I just won't be wearing my hair down very often. Oh my gosh, man, it was like devastating. I can't even, my heart like goes out to anybody that is losing hair because it's like the worst thing. I mean, okay, no, let me stop being dramatic. It's not the worst thing ever. It's just hair, but it is very devastating to see a big old bald spot in the mirror. I could not believe it. I could not believe it. I was like, what in the world is that, man? So anyway, long story, I am headed to Ulta. I called like every Ulta in the area and I was like, please, do you have an appointment? I need to get my hair cut. And so I'm going to the one in Ingram, which I've never been to get my hair cut before. So hopefully, I think a guy named Benjamin is going to do it. So I'm hoping he's good because I'm just gonna get it chopped off. Like, I just don't even know what else to do. And I'm hoping that when I blow dry it and straighten it, that the bald spot gets covered. I guess if it doesn't, I don't even know. I guess I'll just be wearing it up because, oh gosh. So anyway, needless to say, I got my stuff kind of divvied up. I didn't even brush it or anything. I need to check my towel. I'm hoping it didn't fall out in my towel. God, now I have like a headache. I don't know what the heck, man. It's crazy. So anyway, all I did was get my stuff put together. Like, I have three different hauls. I have a Marshall's haul, a Walmart haul, and a Target / baby haul. And I didn't even get to film it. I didn't get any makeup on or anything because all I did was, I didn't even put any moisturizer on my face because as soon as I saw it, I started panicking. So anywho, this is the last time you'll see me with any type of long hair because I will totally be short and styled the next time you see me.
Yeah.
Don't know about.
You see once over there. Okay, here we go.
Can you see it?
Yep, you can see. There you go.
Huh? Do what? Oh, if you want to.
It's already gone.
Oh my gosh, yeah, if you want to. Well, yep, there it is, gone. What color are you doing?
Like a blue, purple, and red.
Oh, I can
red.
See it. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's so cool. Well, there it goes. Oh my gosh.
All I gotta do is just even it out.
Here, I can actually flip it for you, Susan.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Yeah, because it's already clean. It just needs to be.
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah, that was another thing. I've got a lot of it, and it's.
We can go to the bowl. We're gonna go to the shampoo.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm gonna condition it. And then we'll even it out.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem.
You guys are going to flip when you see it. OMG! It's so short! Oh, it's so short! Oh my gosh, it's so short! When he first finished, I was like, oh my god! The only thing I regret is not getting a stronger face frame. Like, I wish instead of it being all one length, I wish I had got a stronger face frame. It's super short. Oh my gosh. But he said I don't have any other bald spots, so I'm not sure if that is just, like part of alopecia or something. I'm gonna go get it checked out especially if it doesn't grow back. But yeah, look, it is so fresh and light for summer. I like can't even get past how light, it feels like I have no hair on my head. It's still super thick, like I can feel how thick it is, and I for sure won't be able to wear it curly for a while. But I don't know. I don't know. I cannot believe I just got like a foot, literally a foot chopped off my hair. I can't believe it. So I can't lie, I just spent the last 20 minutes crying. But it's just hair, it's not the end of the world. And I mean, in theory, I like it. I don't know if I'm just more shocked that so much, like it's so short this time around, so short. I think maybe when it grows out an inch or two, I will be more satisfied with it. But, I mean, it's a cute haircut. I've never had short mom hair like this. I think that's what I'm more devastated by. Everyone likes it. First thing the girls said was that they really liked it. And I had already cried to Andres, so I told him, I was like, you don't count because you would tell me it's beautiful even if it was hideous. Because I was like, you're gonna hate it, it's so short. And he showed me a picture of like a mushroom head type haircut. He's like, that's what I was picturing when you told me that it was super short. So it's cute. I mean, I'll give it that. It's just very short. I'll get past it and used to it. And I think too, once I blow dry it with my own products and get like a feel for it, I'll like it a lot more too. So, and it covers up my bald spot in the back, which I'm gonna need to go get checked out to make sure it's not anything more severe than just a patch of hair that's missing from postpartum hair loss. So anyway, there it is. It's gone for the summertime. And actually by the time we go on vacation, it'll probably be the perfect length. So I guess I'm glad I did it now instead of the week before we go on vacation, then I have to see pictures like this forever. He's laughing at me, rolling his eyes. It's not funny, it's serious. I felt like baking, so we are making some chocolate chip cookies from the Nestle Toll House, the back of it. This is the one that my grandma uses. So I'm literally just following the ingredients that are on here with the instructions. This is the one my grandma uses, so I assume it's tried and true. And I have this big old thing of chocolate chips and all the big old thing of nuts, something to just kind of make myself, I don't know, busy. Feel like I did something today. I didn't even see how many dozen this would make. I made 12 dozen in there. I think there's actually, or 12 dozen, oh, a dozen. I think there's actually 13 of really large cookies because all I had was this scoop. I need to get like 1 inch or a, yeah, I think like a 1 inch, maybe a 2 inch automatic scooper. But that's all I had. So what I did instead of making all of them at once, the rest of the dough, it looks like it may make 3 to 4 dozen. The rest of the dough, I just kind of made it into a tube. Let's see if I can show you here. And I don't have saran wrap. All I have, well, I have saran wrap, but all I have is the cling wrap type, not like just the clear plastic saran wrap. So I wrapped it in freezer paper and I made it into one long dough. I'm gonna cut it in half and then I'm gonna stick this in the freezer. I may put one in the fridge to make more cookies in the next few days and then one in the freezer. I'm assuming this is freezer paper made for like meat, so I'm assuming I could use it on cookies and it would be totally fine. But I'm gonna let it get a little bit hard in the fridge before I cut it and stick it in the freezer, because I think this would be good. I could actually even do like thirds and probably get 6 cookies out of each one. Or no, I could probably, if I do it in thirds, I could probably get 10 cookies out of each one, just like thinner cookies, and then that way we wouldn't have to make like a whole batch of cookies at once. This was a lot, definitely. I mean, it was almost a whole bowl full, so we definitely don't need that many cookies at once. So that's the plan. Let me know if you guys do this to your dough. They actually came out pretty dang close to my grandma's. Various sizes, of course, but oh so delicious. kind of irritated that my little curlies didn't get straightened. My little baby hairs, look at that. How curly. Anywho, I just got done watching the series finale of Switched at Birth and cried like a freaking baby. I'm just having one of those days, feeling sorry for myself, I guess, and because of that, everything's making me emotional. My mom, when she got off work, came and dropped over some leftovers. It's so funny. I think I've mentioned this before, but I don't know if it's because we are the largest. We make up, like, my family, my immediate family makes up the almost half of my entire family. It's because there's five of us and there's only, I feel like 11 of us total. 11? 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yeah. There's only 11 of us, so we make up almost half. So whenever anybody has like leftovers or something in bulk, like Nin is particularly good at this. She will bring us leftovers, like she gets the girls juices and milks and all kinds of stuff, and we just always end up with all the leftovers of everything. So Nin actually brought us some stuff earlier, some coconut water, some spaghetti, whole bunch of stuff. And my mom did the same thing. She called me earlier when I was in my hair crisis, which is growing on me. My mom loves it, by the way. Everybody loved it. The girls loved it. Andres loved it. Well, I mean, he says he does. Mom loved it. Everybody loved it. I posted it on my Facebook. Everybody loved it there. Everyone thinks it's like a cute, makes me look younger type of haircut. I don't know. It'll grow on me. I know it will. I think, like I said earlier, I just need to kind of blow it out myself and see how I feel about it. But anyway, she brought, earlier when I was going through that, she was like, oh, I have food left over, like fish or whatever that they had during lunchtime. I have a bunch of it left over. I was gonna see if you wanted to come get it. And I was like, yeah, maybe I'll come get it. And then I was really upset about my hair and the experience that I had, which, by the way, I would not recommend going to that Ulta in Ingram at all. I usually go to the Ulta in Alamo Ranch, and that Alamo Ranch, I should have just waited for the appointment, but the appointment was like almost 3 hours. I called at 3 o'clock and the appointment was until 5:45, and I was like, nah, I don't want to wait that long. That's like too close to dinner. I don't want to be there too late, whatever. So when I called Ingram, they had an appointment at 4:30. I didn't even get in the chair until like 4:45, almost 5 o'clock. So I could have easily waited for Alamo Ranch and probably got the hairstylist that I've had before, but oh well, it is what it is. It's just hair, right? It's a big deal and I'm pretty upset about it, but in reality, in the grand scheme of things that could be a big deal, it's really not a big deal. So I need to just move past it. But anyway, I was upset about my hair and about the experience, so I didn't want to go pick up the food. So my mom was sweet enough to drop it off after work, and then her and I were just talking in the driveway for like an hour. I was like, Mom, I walked out without shoes because I thought I was just going to pick up the food, and I was like, okay, Mom, gotta go. I was out there for like 45 minutes to an hour. My pedicure was getting all jacked up because I was standing on concrete barefoot, and my hair was, it was windy, so my hair was like blowing all up and down, going everywhere in my face and everything. And so I just came back inside and I just thought that was really sweet. She was like, oh my gosh, I just love it. Why are you unhappy? So I was telling her the whole experience, which was actually a really bad experience. Like when I told him the rest, I've got my hair cut from being super long to short several times since him and I have been together. I want to say like 3 or 4 times. And I've never come home crying. I mean, I've been before like, oh my God, it's so short, I can't believe it, but I've never come home crying over a haircut, never. And it was like not even just as much the haircut as the experience as well, like with the bald spot and everything, which luckily is like my hair does cover it up, thank goodness, because it is significant. I mean, I just couldn't even believe it. And the hairstylist that I went to was a male, and he just made me feel really insecure and stupid about it, which is
never, like, you go, I don't know, I just couldn't even believe it. You go to somebody to do your hair, and you, I don't know, I just feel like they should be supportive, like, not make you feel worse about something, you know? It just was bad all the way around. He was complaining about his job. He was telling me that he hated doing haircuts, that because he had to do a lot of them to meet his quota, and it just was bad. It was bad. Like, he didn't even ask me how short I wanted my hair. He just took my hair in a ponytail and chopped it off. It was just bad. I don't know. I just didn't. And it was, like, too late. By the time I realized I was in a crappy situation, it was too late because he was already done. And he needed to finish it up so that I didn't look any worse than I already did. I won't go back to that one for sure. And honestly, I don't know if I'll get a haircut for a while. I may wait for it to grow out a bit and get some long layers and more of a face frame just to give it some shape. But I won't do anything. And actually, I kind of feel like I want to wash it so that I can blow dry it. He didn't even put any product in it. Isn't that awful? Like, no product, no nothing. Needless to say, I called after much reluctancy. I don't know if that's a word, but I was very reluctant to call. And Andres was like, "You're so upset. Why don't you just call and talk to the manager?" And I hate, like, I'm the first one to complain about something if it's not right, but I hate when I'm emotional about something, complaining. And I was like, I don't know if I'll be able to keep it together. I didn't want to call, but I did call, and the manager's going to give me a refund. I just need to go up there and get a refund for it, which, I mean, I just wasn't happy. I was not happy. And it was $55 for the haircut. So anyway, and then I was even more upset that, like, this guy may be doing this to other people's hair too. I don't know, whatever. It could have been a worse day, for sure. Worse things could have happened. I'm glad that it's over, and I will definitely get used to the haircut and move past it. And as soon as it grows out a little bit, I can style it a little bit differently and get it shaped a little bit different as well. And I think I'll be okay. Now it's just a bald spot. Hopefully that fills it. I guess if it doesn't, I will just live with it for the rest of my life. I don't know. I've had a long day. I almost wish I had gone to work today. I was on call the whole day. I just feel like, but then again, maybe when I went to work, I wouldn't have noticed the bald spot and somebody else would have noticed it. I don't know. So I'm glad today's over. It's after midnight. I'm waiting for the vlog to export so I can get that uploaded and go to bed. I'm tired. My eyes are puffy from crying over freaking shows and crying over my hair. And yeah, I need to go to bed. So tomorrow I work at H&R Block, which I'll be glad when that's done over. 3 more shifts and that'll be done. Sorry, it was one of those days where it was like nonsense for me to feel sorry for myself and be upset, but we're all entitled to one of those every now and then, and today was my day. So I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you guys like the new short hair because it's obviously not going anywhere, and we will see you tomorrow. Bye.